What's going on, guys? It's your man, Ed Hayes, the Wholesale Coach here, back for another podcast. And in this podcast, I'm going to be talking about the eviction moratorium that the federal government put in place to halt evictions and foreclosures and how that's affecting the real estate market. So I hope that you all are pumped for this content. Go ahead, hit that like button for me now, and let's go ahead, let's get into it. All right, guys, so let's just go ahead and get right on into it. So, you know, the eviction moratorium was put in place earlier this year, and just recently at the beginning of September, the eviction moratorium was extended till the end of the year. And these measures have been put in place to, you know, avoid any catastrophes in the real estate market. So unlike other industries, in our country, real estate really hasn't been hit because the government has put measures in place to make sure that we're not having another 2008 right before a presidential election. So it seems quite clear that that's the case. So let's just take a step back. So, you know, when they first put the eviction moratorium in place, let's say this. Had they not put that eviction moratorium in place, there would be tens of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of people homeless right now all across this nation. And because they put those measures in place, it's kind of halted like the Black Friday sale that it could have been for investors all around the nation. So in other words, while this eviction moratorium is going on, from what I've seen so far, it seems as though the numbers are showing less cash buyers and investors in the markets, as well as home sales seem to be rising despite the pandemic that we're in right now or whatever. It's crazy. And part of the reason is because of the measures that the government has put in place. So not only did the government put that pre-foreclosure and eviction moratorium in place, they also lowered interest rates once again to like historic lows, as they always tend to do in situations like this. So that combination has actually allowed people with the same credit score, the same amount of money, all of that good stuff, to be able to go out and afford more home. So therefore, homes are actually selling at and above sales price right now because of those measures that have been taken by the government. So because, you know, in many places around the nation, Las Vegas is one of them, Seattle is another, because of that, because of the moratorium, as well as the lowered interest rates, a lot of people are actually still wanting to purchase. However, because of coronavirus, less people are actually trying to sell their homes. And that's the reason why the price is going up, because demand is definitely there, but supply is lower, which equals the price going up. Good old supply and demand, guys. You know what I mean? It's actually happening out here, and you can really, really see it, though. It really, really makes a lot of sense. So I just wanted to kind of make this podcast, this video or whatever, so people can get an idea of what to expect in the market right now. You know, what I've noticed is that I've a lot of leads, to be honest with you all. That's my phone, by the way, if you all heard that. But to be honest with you all, like, a lot of the leads that I've come across lately have been kind of trash, you know, and like people just are looking for more money than what the properties are worth. I had somebody that wanted $100,000 more. They was dead serious. Oh, are you serious? I don't know what's going on out here. But, you know, it's all good, though, you know, but that's like the type of situations that are happening in different markets throughout the nation. I'm not saying that it's happening everywhere. I'm not saying that, you know, you should be nervous about getting deals or anything like that. Still go hard for your deals. Still do everything in your power. I'm just giving you all the bare bones facts from the research that I've done about the market over the recent period of time. Let's just put it like that. Since Corona has started, and like just recently or whatever, with the extension of the moratorium, I've really been kind of paying attention to what's going on out here. And I was saying it last year, you know, it's going to be like a decline in the real estate market, and a lot of other people were betting on that as well, but it didn't hit like people thought it were going to hit. Like people thought it was going to hit, like they thought it was going to hit rock bottom, it was going to get low, but the government is keeping the real estate industry afloat right now. So I want you all to keep that in mind. The government is keeping the real estate industry afloat, so it's not going to be sustainable. The government is not perpetually gonna, you know, make sure that people aren't gonna get foreclosed on. So therefore, we're living in a bubble right now. Every other industry has gotten destroyed, you know, and housing would have been one of those markets. But like I said earlier, the government doesn't want to have another 2008 housing market crash right before a presidential election. And that makes a lot of sense, to be honest. So, excuse me. Therefore, I believe that the best thing that any one of us can be doing right now is preparing yourself to be ready to be in position to buy. If you aren't in position to buy already, prepare yourself to be in position to buy, because when this bubble burst, I'm telling you right now, when this pre-foreclosure, foreclosure, and like eviction moratorium is over with, it's gonna be chaos. Remember, you heard it here first. I'm just letting y'all know that right now. We are living in a bubble, and as soon as the government is done keeping our real estate market afloat, it's a wrap. I mean, you can just put two and two together and see that right now. I don't really hear people talking about this, but I'm letting y'all know that I'm putting two and two together, and it seems very clear to me that the housing market is going to plummet at some point once this moratorium is over, unless they perfectly time ending the moratorium with like the ending of coronavirus and Like they would pretty much have to keep extending out the moratorium on evictions and foreclosures for it to work out. That's what I feel like would have to happen. Otherwise, yeah, just expect some chaos coming up here soon. My prediction is sometime within the next year, probably within like the next 6 months to a year, is what I'm expecting the bubble to burst. But the eviction moratorium, as far as I know, is only it's set to expire at the end of this year. But I'm going to expect that they may potentially extend it like another time or two, potentially. So I'm expecting within like the next 6 months to a year, you'll be seeing those eviction moratoriums expire. And it's going to be a golden opportunity to buy. Unfortunately, it's going to be really sad for a lot of people. It's going to be like another 2008, potentially. However, it's going to be a great time to buy. So get your ducks in a row. Get that credit score in line. Get ready, because I truly believe that something major is going to be happening soon. But that's pretty much how it's affecting the market right now. Things seem to be a little bit tighter than what it was a little while ago. Like, people are kind of tightening up, especially since that extension of the moratorium. I think a lot of people were expecting for it to expire. So therefore, you know, I say, you know, expect it to keep going like another time or two. Like, they keep extending it out for like another three months, and then it'll probably expire then. So anyway, though, that's just my prediction. I hope that this video and this podcast, wherever you're listening to this at, I hope that this helps you and gives you like a little bit of insight into what could be going on out here in the market coming up here soon. Just remember, if and when it does happen, remember where you heard it first. Anyway, though, guys, share this podcast with others, man. Hit that rate and review button if you haven't already. Subscribe to the channel if you're checking this out on YouTube. And until next time, guys, I am out.